Hello everyone, good morning all of you. Welcome to you all in today's second online session of chapter number 7. And the name of our chapter number 7 is Jerks and Mugs. Now today we are going to study some story sums of your textbooks. Let us see. Who can have 1 liter kheer? Do you like kheer? What do you call it at home? Do you like kheer? Yes, we all usually like kheer. And what is the another name of kheer? What do you call it at your home? So at your home, we call it as doodh paak. Can you drink 1 liter of water at one time? No, we can't drink 1 liter of water at one time. Now here says that one girl, I think I can drink 1 liter water or anything. Whereas the small child says that I can drink only 400 ml. ml represent milliliter. Now here we have to see the different ways to make 1 liter. See here, 1 liter I am giving and you have to find out the different ways. As we know already, 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. If there is a 200 ml, then in 200 ml, what should be added to complete 1 liter, to complete 1000 ml? So 1000 ml is equal to 1 liter. So from this 1000 ml, there is 200 ml. What should be added in 200 to make 1000? So we can say that it is a 800 ml. So we can say that 800 milliliter plus 200 milliliter is equal to 1 liter. Now, your another way to make 1 liter. 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. From this 1000 milliliter, 200 milliliter they were given. So, what is the remaining? 1000 minus 250. 750 ml is remaining. So how we can make 750 ml? So we can say that 500 ml plus 250 ml, that is the 750 ml, 750 ml plus 250 ml. The sum of this 3 milliliter to complete 1000 milliliter. Now another way to make, to complete the 1000 ml. So we can say that 400 milliliter plus 600 milliliter is equal to 1000 milliliter. Another way that already given to you, if you want to make the 1000 milliliter, then just do the addition of 500 milliliter plus 500 milliliter. It completes 1000 milliliter. As you already studied in your third standard, if you want to make the addition of any number, then there are too much different ways to complete it. Now your another way to make 1 liter, if they were given 1000 milliliter to you, so from that 1000, 100 milliliter they were given. So how much remaining? 900 milliliter is remaining. So how we can make 900? Just do make 2 equal parts of 900. So 900 is equal to, we can say that 450 ml plus 450 ml. It completes 1000 ml. 450 plus 450 plus 100 is equal to 1000 1000 milliliter. Then again, if we are just adding the three number 200 milliliter plus 500 milliliter plus 300 milliliter, then it completes 1 liter. 200 plus 500, 700. 700 plus 300 is equal to 1000 milliliter. So here you can use another different numbers to complete 1 liter. Collect the 1 liter bottle and some small bottle. What you have to do? You have to first collect one big bottle, and the measurement of big bottle is 1 liter. And after that, you have to collect some other small bottles. Guess how many times you have to pour from each of the small bottles to fill the liter bottle. Now what you have to do? You have to take anything, liquid things in your small bottle, and you have to fill the big bottle. So the measurement of big bottle is 1000 ml, and the small bottle which you collect, that is the measurement of that thing is different. So you have to find out how many times you fill the small bottle to fill the big bottle. Let us see. Here in the table, I am giving bottle, then milliliter, and then times. Let us see. First bottle. The measurement of first bottle is 100 ml. It means in that bottle, we can fill 100 milliliter. Now from this bottle, we have to fill the big bottle. So how many times we have to pour the water in a small bottle to complete 1 liter bottle? So which number multiply by 100? So you get 1000 milliliter. So 100 multiply by 10 is equal to 1000 milliliter. So we can say that if we fill small bottle 10 times, then you can fill the big bottle of 1 liter. Let us see. Bottle 2. Measurement of that bottle 2 is 200 ml. So which number multiply by 200 to make 1000 milliliter? So 200 multiply by 5 is equal to 1000 milliliter. So if we are filling small bottle 5 times, then we can fill 1 liter bottle. Now if the measurement of bottle 3 is 50 milliliter, then which number multiply by 50, then you make 1000 milliliter. So which number multiply by 50, then you get 1000. So what you have to do? You just do the division of this both, 1000 divided by 50. Just do the division, 1000 divided by 50. So your answer is 20. So if you are filling 20 times bottle number 3, then you can fill 1 big bottle of 1 liter. Now bottle number 4. The measurement of bottle number 4 is 250 milliliter. So how many times we fill 250 milliliter bottle to complete 1 liter? So which number multiply by 250, then you get 1000. So we can say that 1000 divided by 250 is equal to 4. So if we fill 4 times bottle number 4, then we can fill 1 liter of bottle. Now the measurement of bottle number 5 is 500 ml. So how many times we have to fill bottle number 5 to make 1 liter? It means 1000 milliliter. So 500 plus 500. So it is 2 times. If we fill bottle number 5 2 times, then we can fill 1 whole 1 liter of bottle. Aditya poured 2 small bottles of water to fill 1 liter bottle. How much water does his small bottle hold? Now see here what they are telling. Just understand. Aditya poured 2 small bottles of water. Aditya have 2 small bottle, water bottle, and from this 2 bottle he has to be fill 1 whole bottle, and the measurement of that big bottle is 1 liter. How much water does his small bottle hold? So now here you have to find out what is the measurement, what is the capacity of small bottle. Here you have to assume that the capacity, the size of these 2 bottle is same. So we can say that the capacity of small bottle is 500 ml. How it comes? See, as you know already, 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. So just do the division, 1000 divided by 2. So your answer is 500 milliliter. Now, to fill the 1 liter bottle, Leela needs to pour water 5 times from her small bottle. Then how much water does Leela's bottle hold? Now see here, what Leela wants to do? Leela wants to fill 1 liter bottle. Now to fill that 1 liter bottle, she filled the water in the bottle 5 times. Now in this they were not given the measurement, the capacity of bottle. So again in this you have to find out how much water does Leela's bottle hold. So here we have to say that the capacity of the small bottle is 200 milliliter. How it comes? 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter divided by how many times she filled the bottle, her small bottle, 5 times. So 1000 divided by 5 is equal to 200 milliliter. Neetu has to take 3 injections in a day for 5 days. Now how many injections she has to be take? She has to be take 3 injections in a day. A day means 1 day. In a 1 day, she has to take 3 injections. And this 3 injections, she has to be taken for 5 days. After that, 1 injection gives 5 milliliter of the medicine to her body. It means we can say that in a 1 injection there is 5 milliliter of medicine. Now you have to find out how much medicine will she need for 1 day. So for a 1 day, how much medicine she will need? Let us see. In a 1 day, 3 injections she take. In a 1 day, need to take 3 injections. So we can say that 1 multiplied by 3 is equal to she has to be take 3 injections in a 1 day. Now, the medicine for the one day, in a one injection, 5 milliliter of medicine is there. So 5 ml milliliter multiply by 3. Why multiply by 3? Because in a one day she has to be take 3 injection, therefore. And 5 milliliter multiply by 3 milliliter is equal to 5 threes are 15 milliliter. Now the total injection in 5 days, she has to be taken 3 injection in a one day. So in a 5 days, how many injections she has to be taken? 5 multiply by 3 is equal to 15 injection. So for the 5 days she has to be take 15 injection. And what about the total medicine in a one injection? 5 milliliter is there. So in a 15 injection, 5 milliliter multiply by 15 injection is equal to 75 milliliter. Now here you have to make some list of the things which we use for more than 1 liter at a time. At a time means in a one time we are using more than 1 liter of water. So for bath, taking bath, we are using more than 1 liter of water. Then water for washing clothes, to wash the clothes we are using more than 1 liter of water. Then when we fill our car tanks or bike or anything, petrol or diesel, to fill up the tank of a car, in that we are using more than 1 liter. Then water to wash the kitchen utensils, to wash the kitchen utensils we are using more than 1 liter of water. Now Amina's water bottle hold 1 liter of water. Now the capacity, the measurement of Amina's water bottle is 1 liter, and 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. She drank 250 ml of water. Out of that 1000 milliliter, she drank only 250 milliliter. And her friend Govind drank 150 milliliter. How much water is left in the bottle? So here, as we know already, the 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliter. So the capacity of the water bottle is 1000 milliliter. Now, the total water drunk by Amina and her friend. So water drunk by Amina plus water drunk by Govind. So that is the 250 milliliter plus 150 milliliter. The addition of this both is 400 milliliter. Now this 400 milliliter Amina and Govind use. Now how much water is left in the bottle? So the water left in the bottle is equal to 1000 milliliter minus 400 milliliter. So 1000 minus 400 is equal to 600 milliliter. So we can say that 600 milliliter water is left in the bottle. Now let us see. Yusuf runs a tea shop. For making a glass of tea, he uses 20 milliliter of milk. If he wants to make a tea, then he uses 20 milliliter of milk. Yesterday he made 100 glasses of tea. How much milk did he use? So we can say that for making a 1 glass of tea, milk used is 20 milliliter. So for making the 100 glass of tea, how much milk is used? So we can say that 100 multiply by 20 milliliter. So three zeros are there. So you just put the 3 0 and then 2 ones are 2. So 2000 milliliter. He used to make 100 glasses of tea. And as we know already, 2000 milliliter is equal to 2 liter. How it comes? Because as we know already, 1000 milliliter is equal to 1 liter. Therefore, 2000 milliliter is equal to 2 liter. So, he used 2 liter of milk to make 100 glasses of tea. Now, Radha's grandma was ill. The doctor gave her a bottle with 200 milliliter of medicine. She has to take the medicine for every morning for 10 days. How many milliliter of medicine does she have to take every morning? See here. The capacity of the bottle is 200 milliliter. Out of this 200 milliliter, she has to take how much medicine for 10 days. Here they were not given the capacity, the measurement for the 1 day. How many milliliters she has to be take for 1 day, that we have to find out. So what we have to do? We have to just do the division of 200 milliliter divided by number of days. See here, 200 milliliter, that is the total capacity of bottle, and she has to be complete this bottle in 10 days. So 200 divided by 10 days is equal to 20 milliliter. So Radha's grandma has to take 20 milliliter of medicine every morning. Thank you. I hope you all understand this all things very easily.